Once upon a time, in a small village nestled between rolling hills and babbling brooks, there lived a loving mother named Sanmo and her curious and adventurous daughter, Zainabo. Sanmo was known throughout the village for her kindness and wisdom. She had a heart as warm as the sun and a smile that could brighten even the cloudiest day. Zainabo, on the other hand, was a bundle of energy, always eager to explore the world around her.
One sunny morning, as the golden rays of the sun painted the sky, Sanmo decided to take Zainabo on a special adventure. They set out on a journey through the enchanting forest that bordered their village. The trees whispered secrets, and the colorful flowers nodded in greeting as the duo walked hand in hand.
As they strolled deeper into the forest, Zainabo's eyes widened with wonder. The trees seemed to reach for the sky, and the air was filled with the sweet fragrance of blooming flowers. Suddenly, a mischievous squirrel named Squeaky appeared, chattering away and leading them to a magical clearing. In the middle of the clearing stood a majestic tree with shimmering leaves that sparkled like emeralds. Sanmo explained that this was the wishing tree, a tree that granted wishes to those with pure hearts. Excitement bubbled in Zainabo's chest as she thought about what she would wish for. Sanmo gently encouraged Zainabo to make her wish first. With a twinkle in her eye, Zainabo closed her eyes tightly, made a wish, and whispered it to the wishing tree. Suddenly, a shower of golden dust rained down, and a tiny winged creature appeared, a wish fairy. The wish fairy told Zainabo that her wish would come true, but there was one condition. Zainabo had to promise to spread kindness and joy wherever she went. Zainabo eagerly agreed, and with a wave of the wish fairy's wand, they were back in the village. From that day forward, Zainabo and Sanmo became known for their acts of kindness. Zainabo's wish had brought a special magic to their lives, and the village flourished with laughter and joy. The people in the village often said that the warmth of Sanmo's heart and the sparkle in Zainabo's eyes had a magical effect on everyone around them.
And so, the tale of Sanmo and Zainabo became a cherished story in the village, passed down from generation to generation. The wishing tree continued to stand tall in the enchanted forest, ready to grant the pure-hearted wishes of those who believed in the magic of kindness. In the village where Sanmo and Zainabo lived, the houses were adorned with vibrant flowers, and the winding cobblestone paths led to charming cottages. Sanmo was not only known for her kindness, but also for her skills in traditional crafts. She was often seen weaving colorful baskets and creating intricate patterns on fabrics. Zainabo loved helping her mother with these crafts, and together, they made the most beautiful creations that adorned the village square. With her curly hair and a perpetual twinkle in her eyes, she was a favorite among the village children. They loved to gather around her as she shared tales of magical creatures and faraway lands. Her adventurous spirit and boundless imagination made her stories come alive, and the children eagerly awaited the next tale. As for the mischievous squirrel, Squeaky, he became Zainabo's loyal forest companion. Whenever they ventured into the woods, Squeaky would join them, leading the way with his chattering and playful antics. There are other animals in the forest, from wise old owls to graceful deer, considered Zainabo and Sanmo their friends, and would often share their own stories and wisdom. The magical clearing where the wishing tree stood became a secret meeting place for the village children. They would gather there to make. As for the mischievous squirrel, Squeaky, he became Zainabo's loyal forest companion. Whenever they ventured into the woods, Squeaky would join them, leading the way with his chattering and playful antics. There are other animals in the forest, from wise old owls to graceful deer, considered Zainabo and Sanmo their friends, and would often share their own stories and wisdom.